Testing, testing, 1, 2. Good evening to you, ladies and gentlemen. You are tuning in to Funky Gamer across Mixer, YouTube, and Twitch. My name is Rickie, and this evening we're going to be embarking on, well, continuing on, should I say, from our recent escapades into the Telltale universe of games. Yesterday night we finished Batman, the second season, The Enemy Within, and that was really good. Tonight, we're going to continue rather randomly, about halfway through Guardians of the Galaxy. Now, disclaimer, apologies, this is not going from the beginning. I have done myself a boo-boo. Yeah, I started playing it before I started streaming it. But I do find that these are a really good medium for streaming, especially if you're German, because German people fucking love adventure games. I don't know what it is. Anyway, I welcome it wherever you're from. We'll be starting in just a couple of minutes. I've not got any background music on at the moment. I normally stream from my cap card, but it's playing heavily copyrighted music, and I do not wish to get myself stricken. Thanks for tuning in. This is Rickie at Funky Gamer. We'll be going in a couple of minutes' time. Okay, I think we're just about sorted. Further disclaimer. So, for those of you that are curious, if not observant, I am from the UK. In the UK right now, I can't tell you what the temperature is, other than it's fucking warm. I reckon it's at least 25, 26 degrees, and I understand, right, most people that are from anywhere that's outside of the UK, I guess, will probably be sitting there thinking to themselves, what the hell are you talking about? That is not heat. We have 50, 60. Yeah, it's fine. It's not a competition. I'm just warning you, I'm dying, so I apologise. Let's do this. Fuck it. Let's see if I can just not screw up the audio here as well. Get the hell off. Goddamn chat. So this is episode 3 of Telltale's Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy. I think that's the official name. I'm not sure. Marvel's Telltale's Guardians. Some variation on that.
You don't know a lot about me, but before I met you guys, there was someone.
I can't remember what happened last time I played this at all.
She's gone now. but maybe with that relic I can make her ungone.
I know you've got a lot on your mind, but that kid you fought, maybe he does too. Promise me in the future you'll use your words instead of your fists.
I will, Mom. I promise.
Thank you, baby.
The Eternity Forge resides here, pending such time as it can be wielded responsibly. Until then, she shall remain entombed across the galaxy.
Come find me, Peter. I'll be waiting for you.
Oh, it's... I thought I was controlling it. That recap made my life less easy, by the way. I still have no clue what the hell is happening here.
I got it, Mom.
Thanks, baby. Ugh.
Another headache?
Just a little one. Stop worrying. It's fine. Just took me by surprise.
I meant to press A.
Stop.
I'm better at this than I may seem.
Better get that prescription before the pharmacy closes. Stay out of trouble till I get back, okay? Be good. I know that's not always easy for you.
I'll be a perfect little angel, like always.
I better hurry back then. I'll be back soon.
Hey, Pete.
Hey, Mr. Pinkle.
Here to get that mixtape copied?
Yeah.
Mr. Pinkle.
Sure is a nice thing to do for your mom. How's she doing anyway?
Just copy the tape.
Just copy the tape, please.
Will do. Both sides? Come back in about an hour and it'll be ready.
Hey, Petey! You make that mix for your boyfriend?
You know what I'm gonna pick.
I made it for your mom.
Watch it, or you'll be swallowing your own teeth. Afraid I'm gonna break it again?
You afraid I'm gonna hit you again?
Listen to you. Pretending you got balls! Hey, how's that lip doing? Give me that. What are you doing here anyway? You don't have money. Everyone in town's talking about it. Your mom can't even pay her medical bills. She's been going door to door asking for help like some pathetic loser. She's probably off looking for change in the sewers right now. Yeah, maybe she'll get lucky and find a quarter.
Come on. Let's not do this, man.
Do what?
We're just talking.
You gonna cry now? Huh? What are you gonna do about it?
Be the bigger man. I'm gonna use my words.
You done yet? Elephant ears? You must get great reception with those things.
Nah, I'm not done. But your mom? She sure is. My dad goes drinking with her doctor. Told him everything. Guess she didn't feel like it was important enough to tell you. Oh, check it out. Dead woman walking. What's the point? Drugs ain't gonna help. My dad says you're gonna die anyway.
My mom's gonna be fine. She just needs the right medicine.
Get her some poison. At least then she won't be wasting money trying to get
better.
Get out!
My dad's gonna-
Out!
That's the least that little shite deserved.
You kept your promise. You didn't fight that jerk. I'm proud of you, Peter. Even though I didn't set a very good example. The things he said. I let my emotions get the better of me.
You slapped him. That was awesome.
No, that was not awesome, Peter.
He said you were dying, Mom. Is that true?
Find me, please. You're so close, Peter.
Nice.
How did I get home? Hey. Are you okay? Because this temple is really messing with my head.
Hello, Gamora. Whoa! Hey! Whoa.
Come on, Nebula.
What are you doing?
You can do better than that.
I'm not him.
Not Nebula. It's me, Peter. Whole lot, and definitely do not want to kill! Come on, this isn't fair! I don't have a sword!
Nebula.
Oh.
You need to be aware of everything around you. Perception's just as important as strength and speed.
None of them are important when I'm stuck here. I want to use what you've taught me somewhere outside of this room. I'm sick of just doing the same thing over and over, every single day.
Be patient, Nebula. You'll get your chance soon enough.
So now I need patience, too? Looks like you've lost your touch.
Hardly.
Cheeky bitch. I'm gonna kick your ass. Oh shit, totally missed that.
That was actually a little impressive.
Just a little.
I'm the only person that can be bad at Telltale
Gamora,
games.
You're hurting me.
Wow. Decisions B, maybe? I'm a nice person.
Nebula, you have grown so much.
Father,
You may yet be the greatest assassin in the galaxy. Don't you agree, Gamora?
I'm gonna stick up, bro.
She's come a long way.
What a pleasant surprise. Perhaps being bested by your sister recalled the importance of humility. I have a mission for you. You will go to a Kree outpost on the planet of Phalion. There you will find General Tarval. He has come into possession of something I require, a device. Gamora, you will fetch the device for me. You, Nebula, you will kill the General.
Thank you, Father. I promise you, I will succeed.
I know you will, daughter. Gamora, you were always my favorite, but you have become cold, distant, forcing me to look to Nebula to tighten the slack, whether I believe she's capable or not.
I disagree.
We will not disappoint you, Father.
But you already have, Gamora. Otherwise, you would not be taking Nebula with you. Go and prepare. You will head out immediately. And Gamora, I know you no longer care, but if you fail, your sister will pay for your missteps. Tell Nebula I wish to speak with her.
Is everything all right?
Adjusted the game sound slightly. Increased it by a couple of decibels.
I couldn't hear you, but Father, he didn't look happy. Gamora?
I can't stand this place anymore. I can't stand him anymore.
Nebula? Come here.
I guess this is it. My chance to prove myself. Or fail miserably.
Don't worry, Nebula. I've got your back.
No. I've got to do this myself. It's what I've been training for. I won't let Father down. Let's just do this.
Subtle. Oh shit. That was close. Good job you have more than one chance to redeem yourself. Tired, long week. I'm gonna blame it on that.
There you are.
Move! I'm your whip.
Thank you.
Nebula! Nebula, are you all right? Are you hurt?
Why? Why did you do that?
What?
I had him. That was my kill and you took it from me! Father will be so upset with me.
I won't tell Thanos, I promise. We'll keep it to ourselves.
Father.
Ooh.
Give me the device.
Nebula, what are you doing?
Some betrayal.
You took my kill. Give me the device in exchange. Give it to me. Now! I'm not asking here. Do it. Gamora, hand it over.
Fine.
Fine. Here. Hey, it's going to be fine. We're going to be okay.
Oh, treachery. The shame.
I was trying to snap you out of it before you killed me.
Well, that's not the way to do it.
Well, apparently it was. Stop. Stop slapping me. Okay.
That's funny.
I'll call.
Don't do that again.
Is it?
Oh. I don't know what happened. One minute you and I were walking into the temple, and the next
I know.
Wait, were you? Did you see all that? My memory?
Are you okay?
I never wanted to think of that time in my life again. I've really been trying to let Nebula go. But seeing that, she thought I was being selfish, taking away everything she worked so hard to achieve. That's why she turned on me, and why she'll never forgive what I did.
I saw what happened. You were just trying to protect her. You can't blame yourself for that.
I'm not so sure. That last moment, it became everything. All I remembered of her. There were times we were happy, despite Thanos, despite everything. We had each other. Maybe I could have done more. Been more honest with how I was feeling. Stopped just seeing her as someone I needed to protect.
Gamora, she didn't want your help. She wanted to prove herself on her own, even if it meant hurting you.
I know, but Nebula is who she is because of me. That hatred, that coldness, her inability to trust anyone. She is Thanos' daughter. Who else could she be after I betrayed her? I failed her.
X.
Listen to me. You didn't fail her. You don't fail at anything. You are the strongest person I know, okay? And I respect the hell out of you for that. And I don't just mean the ass kicking. I mean, believe me, you kick some serious ass.
I do kick a lot of ass, huh?
Hell yeah, you do. Now come on. Let's figure out why the Forge brought us here before things get even more. Weird.
What a great song.
Oh, man. My mom loved this song. She played that record non-stop.
You can't beat a bit of Jeff Lynne and the Electric Light Orchestra, said Alan Partridge.
Peter, wait. This place, it seems to be using our memories against us. We don't know what we'll find inside, or why it's been drawing us here.
Don't worry, okay? I can handle whatever happens, I promise.
I've heard that before.
Oh, come on, that time I died? That totally doesn't count.
Lead on then, but carefully. Do you recognize this place?
Yeah. This is where my mom... This is where I saw her last.
I don't know what all this means, Peter. But I hope somehow you get your mom back.
Only one way to know?
One way to find out.
Done a poo. God, that scared the crap out of me. I have never heard this remix. Crazy. This episode feels like it's going really fast. Oh, but the next one's ready. Yeah. Friday night, ladies and gentlemen. Get in. Maybe that wasn't sarcastic enough. Like a proper Family Guy flop. Who are you?
Who are you?
You have known me for a while now.
Not your mom, right?
Definitely not.
You came for me. After all these... Ooh, what are these? They're very shiny.
Hey, over here.
Peter Quill. You're really here. It's been centuries.
The name's Star-Lord, baby.
You were the first, the only,
yep,
to arrive.
The name's Star-Lord, baby.
Oh, I see. Star-Lord baby.
No, it's just, it's Star-Lord. Legendary outlaw. Why does this never work?
Whoa! Thank you.
You're welcome.
May I borrow that?
No.
Your gun. It will only be for a moment.
I'm gonna do it. Against my better judgment.
Yeah, sure.
What?
I have another one.
Make it better. That wasn't making it better.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
It is so wonderful to be free of that tomb. No longer trapped in my own mind. Alone. You are truly the hero the legends foretold. So brave and handsome.
This chick knows me well.
Though, perhaps not in the classical sense.
What?
Ha! You must have many questions for me.
Ditto. Where's my mom?
I crossed the entire galaxy because my mom was calling to me, asking me to come find her. Where is she?
She is dead.
Cheers.
Your mother, Meredith, she is alive in your memory.
Yeah, that doesn't explain anything.
I have been waiting for you all this time. The moment you touched the forge, I knew you were the Celestial One, that you could free me. So I reached out to you the only way I could, through your memories. The ones most vivid to you, but you must understand, I had no control over them.
That is kind of cool.
I was only trying to communicate. Yay! You like my abilities. Most people run away from me.
There's still time. How could you possibly know how he feels?
I can show you, angry lady. Oh, no. Never mind. May I show you? Please. I mean no harm. Watch. Star-Lord baby is filled with worry about you. He likes when you hit people. Is that right?
Maybe.
Do it again! Come on!
With great pleasure!
Oh, this isn't going to go well.
Sorry.
What emotion was that?
Nothing.
I do not believe I should say out loud. Sexual. You see,
that's out loud.
I am an empath. I can read the emotions of others. It is my duty to help the Celestial One decide the fate of the Forge.
That could really come in handy.
Oh, she's got to meet the rest of the group.
Yeah, introduce an emotionally charged being to a group who are emotionally sensitive. Who should we try on first?
My brain's telling me to go with Drax, but my heart's totally going Rocket. Because she'll piss him off. I think she'll piss them all off. Let's just go with Drax.
I got just the one.
Cheese again.
What is this? Why are her head tentacles glowing?
The big green tattoo man is filled with sadness.
What? No.
He lacks direction.
I do not lack direction. Only once have I required a map.
Now he is ashamed for his outburst.
Mantis is an empath, Drax. She can sense your emotions.
I do not show emotion!
She's also the one who made us relive our memories.
That was you? We went halfway across the galaxy, got chased by that psycho Hala for a party trick?
It is my job to guide the Celestial One.
What the hell does that mean?
The Celestial One?
You messed with our minds. Why?
I am Groot.
She thinks I'm someone called the Celestial One. How about that?
Celestial what?
Why is there only one? And could that one also be me?
Oh, I can explain. Long ago...
Wait. Are you gonna spew some long mumbo-jumbo about where you come from and why I should care?
Yes. Is that a problem?
Remember Thanos? Going on like, now that I got this, I'm gonna roll through the galaxy like a giant turd and blah, blah, blah. The answer is magic. It's always magic. And that is good enough for me.
Her story might be important.
Yep. Well, might as well go the lore route.
I hear it. All of it.
Then it's time for a nap.
Go ahead, Mantis. Enlighten us.
Of course, Star-Lord baby. I have communicated only through my feelings for years.
That chuckles me.
It is nice to communicate with my mouth. Eons ago, the Eternity Forge coalesced into existence as a way to balance the life energy of the universe. To create, you must destroy. And to destroy, you must create. But such colossal power cannot be wielded lightly. So I was brought in to ensure that the Forge was only wielded by someone deserving, and to help guide the wielder down the right path. But I waited. And waited. Years went by. Many unworthy tried to use the Forge. Some even tried to force me to help them. The Kree decided that no culture had matured enough to use the Forge with the wisdom required. Eventually, the Forge and I were separated, locked away until a time when civilizations could reach the peak of wisdom and maturity. And that is only the beginning.
Well, thanks a lot for that, Pete.
What an interesting and relevant story.
That's exactly what
I
was thinking.
We heard it all, champ?
Word for word.
Someday, Quill, I'm gonna blast you out an airlock.
I have not yet gotten to the most important part.
Kill me.
There is a legend of the Celestial One, the chosen one who shall arrive from the stars to use the Eternity Forge.
This Celestial One, what are they like?
Advanced intellect, emotionally mature, wise being capable of navigating the dark waters of immense power. Someone who can see beyond his own selfish desires to choose for the greater good.
That describes me pretty perfectly.
Hey, come on, guys. Hey,
that's just the funny option. Yeah.
It is not funny. Peter is the Celestial One.
Oh, you're so full of crap, lady. If Pete is this Celestial what's it, then why didn't the stupid Forge work? Sure, it brought him back. But when we tried to use it again on someone else, it didn't do a damn thing.
Your loss. I can feel it has been with you for some time. The Forge is limited right now. It can only restore life to a body that is mostly whole and undeteriorated.
I am Groot.
Well, that sucks.
Yes, it does.
Who is sucking what?
No, he means... That is unfortunate.
It does not have to suck.
What do we gotta do?
The Celestial One must deliver the Forge to the sacred shrine. There you can unlock its true power, or destroy it forever.
And that true power is what?
returning anyone from any time period back to the realm of the living. Lost ones, loved ones, I suppose hated ones too, if you were so inclined, though I do not know why. That seems ill-advised, but it is Peter's decision to make.
Why would I destroy the forge? This thing sounds awesome.
Hala!
Its awesomeness comes with a price. Life energy cannot be made. It must be transferred.
So someone still has to die for the thing to work.
Then let's finish our drinks and go use this thing.
Yes!
Really? Who are you planning to kill?
Well, you're kind of annoying me right
now. Hala wants to use this forge to raise her army. We have to destroy it.
Not until my family is returned to me.
I am Groot.
Right? Groot says he's on my side. That's 3-1, Gamora. We win.
That is not true. Groot feels the opposite.
Maybe something got lost in translation. Hey, you try understanding I am Groot all the time. Those three words can mean anything. Don't look at me like that.
Okay, not cool, man. Don't lie to us.
I'm sorry, I just don't want that thing destroyed until we use it. Oh, and lying to you, that was a one-time thing.
I am Groot.
Okay, a two-time thing.
So, it is a tie then.
Two for using it.
I am Groot.
I'm gonna take a guess. He said two for destroying it.
Don't you get what this means? We can bring back anyone that we lost.
At a cost.
No cost is too high.
Wow. Okay, this is, it's a lot to process here. Kind of heavy on the responsibility, you know? Let me think on it. Well, one way or another, this all ends at the shrine. Can you take us there, Mantis?
I have never been, but with your help, I believe I can sense its location. May we have some space to concentrate?
Gladly. If anyone needs me, I'll be emotionally unavailable.
And that's new.
Ha ha ha.
What are you doing?
Helping?
Maybe it is best if you sit still.
Right, of course.
I cannot sense the shrine. There is so much unrest among your crew. Their emotions are overwhelming me. They look to you for guidance. Help them.
Okay. In whatever way I can, I will.
Is it okay if we talk while you do this, or...?
Honestly, I really do need to focus on this.
Do you need to... Yeah, okay, yeah, got it.
I am sorry. I do not mean to be unsociable. Perhaps we can chat later.
Sure thing. Okay, let's try Drax.
Calm down.
Drax, how are you doing?
I was angry that you did not allow me to guard Nebula.
But that...
But now, I am hopeful. The Forge can bring my family back, if you choose to use it.
Well, I...
So I must trust you would not take away my chance to reunite with my wife and daughter. Even though you did not behave in a trustworthy manner.
Huh?
You had no right to have the antenna woman do that to me. You did not even ask my permission. That is the height of offense, Peter Quill.
I just wanted to know what was going on. And here.
In my chest.
In your heart.
It is pumping blood.
Blood and feelings, buddy. Blood and feelings.
She told me I was afraid. I do not like to feel afraid. Such feelings bring me great shame. But talking to you a frequently scared person has helped.
Yeah. Anytime, Drax.
I don't think Peter calls scary.
Hey there, Groot. Oh. Is that a friend of yours?
I am Groot.
I'll tell you this. We're all gonna be okay. No matter what happens with the Forge.
I am Groot.
And Rocket.
Hey, bud, what's up?
Well, if it ain't Captain Indecision.
What are you?
I don't know what's holding you back from doing the right thing here, Quill. I mean, I could count on one paw how many folks ever get a chance to bring back someone they love.
I am Groot.
I'm not gonna kill.
I'm not gonna kill someone to use this thing. End of story.
You already did. We killed Thanos, remember? And it saved you. You know, come to think of it, I wish the Forge had never brought you back. Yeah.
I am Groot.
It should have brought someone else. Anyone else back instead. Better than your worthless hide.
You don't mean that, Rocket.
Now you're telling me what I don't mean. Man the ego on you. I meant every damn word.
I am Groot.
Have a nice night.
Well, that's one way to clear his emotional unrest.
I am Groot.
Fine. 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 Fine.
Hey, are you okay? What the hell was that?
I tried to say everything I could think of. I thought maybe if I asked her to stick around for a while. Ugh. She won't hear it. Not from me. She'll barely even look at me.
So don't give up on her. Family is always worth it.
I know. I'm really trying. But I just can't find the right words with her. But maybe if we had more time, I could try talking to her again when she's calmed down. Give her some space without losing her altogether.
Well, they say time heals all wounds.
Who's they?
I have no idea.
Maybe I can get her to hang around. Just maybe not right now. Think she needs some alone time.
Any luck yet?
I'm afraid not. Someone here remains very unsettled, emotionally.
Ah.
Hey, Nebula. Yeah, hey, it's me, Peter Quill, but, yeah, but you know that. You mind if I sit? Cool, yeah, this is really, how's the arm?
It's not bad. Would have come in handy to have both arms while fighting off the Kree. I suppose I'm lucky you let me out at all. So, thanks, I guess.
It was a trust exercise, I think.
Like I said then, it was just a trust exercise. You passed.
Pretty sure Gamora still needs convincing. Speaking of my dear sister, bet you got an earful. What'd she say about me? That I'm a waste of space. That I deserve everything I've been through.
Gamora says she still cares about you.
She sure has a funny way of showing it. Gamora doesn't even realize that she's the reason our family ended.
Yeah, well, that's not how it looked to me.
What do you mean?
When we were in the temple, I saw Gamora's memory of your last mission.
Oh, yeah? What did you see?
I saw you stab her and leave her to die.
You have no idea what really happened that day. And neither does Gamora. Not all of it, at least.
Then show me.
Now, please take my hand.
If this kills me, I'm going to kick your ass. Is everything all right? What's going on?
I can't stand this place anymore. I can't stand him anymore.
Nebula? Come here.
Oh, do we see the other side of the conversation here? I wonder.
My favorite daughter.
Father.
Your attacks against your sister were swift, precise. You disarmed Gamora easily. I was impressed.
I don't think I won on my own. Gamora let me win.
Because she is a coward. She could not face true defeat. Don't let her weakness diminish your strength. There is something you must know about Gamora. She said she would not disappoint me. But I am not so sure. Every day, she grows more agitated and bitter as she watches you surpass her. You've seen her lack of respect. She disobeys me time and time again. I no longer trust her. You shouldn't trust her either, Nebula. Gamora has become a risk to our family.
I know she's been difficult, but Gamora won't fail you, Father.
I caution you to be careful with your sister. That is all I ask. If she continues to be a problem, you might take her place. Stand by my side as my greatest warrior and only daughter. Gamora makes herself more useless, more unreliable with each passing day. Where she fails, you thrive.
Father, I need Gamora. She's my teacher and my sister.
You underestimate yourself, Nebula. This mission will prove that. This is your moment. Go and prepare. Keep your communications open. I'll be monitoring the situation.
I'm not too sure how I missed that.
No!
Nebula! Nebula, are you all right? Are you hurt?
Why? Why did you do that?
What?
I had him. That was my kill and you took it from me!
I won't tell Thanos, I promise. We'll keep it to ourselves.
Nebula.
Father.
You don't need Gamora anymore. And neither do I. If you don't get rid of her, I will do it myself. Only I will ensure that your sister suffers greatly.
Give me the device.
Nebula, what are you doing?
You took my kill. Give me the device in exchange. Give it to me, now! I'm not asking here.
Fine, here. Hey, it's going to be fine. We're going to be okay.
Is it done?
What's going on?
Intriguing.
What are you making him see?
It wasn't over.
Oh, man! We were just getting to the part where she, you know...
What?
The part where she kills you?
I tried to show him what really happened with Tarval, but you interrupted us.
I'm sorry. I didn't know what was going on.
But you naturally assumed the
worst.
What
do you expect after everything that's happened?
Hey!
She was always pushing against Thanos, testing his limits. What happened was her fault.
Yeah. I practically shoved that knife into my own gut. Too bad I had such terrible aim. Some assassin.
Gamora, I wasn't trying to kill you.
Oh yeah? Then what were you doing? Because it looked exactly like you were trying to kill me.
She wanted to be Thanos' only daughter. She wanted to take your place by his side.
I always wanted that. It's true. But that's not how I wanted to get it. I saved your
life! Admit it. You just wanted to prove you were better than me. By killing
me. If I wanted to kill you, you'd be dead! Thanos was going to kill you himself. There would have been nothing left of you. Do you know? I even checked your pulse. Just to make sure you were still alive. You never got to see that part. The most important part. But I did.
That doesn't make any sense.
I'm kind of believing her here, Gamora. She hadn't fake killed you. I'm pretty sure Thanos would have been a lot more thorough.
It's possible. I don't know what to believe.
I'm just trying to keep us together. You're my family. Oh, so you finally agree with me about something. What a surprise!
I'm just as surprised as you. I figured you'd disagree with me just because that's what you do.
Well, I'm not used to you saying anything I'd have-
Guys! Guys! Stop! You both want the same thing!
He's actually right.
It happens, sometimes.
More than sometimes. Thank you.
Maybe we could give each other a chance?
All right.
Peter, I can finally sense the shrine.
Okay.
Cool.
Let's
guess.
Let's go. Well,
it isn't my favorite assassin sisters.
Well, that'd be a pretty rad band name.
Hey, Peter. Give me 1 second. I'll meet you in my room.
Sure. Quill.
Thank you for talking to Nebula. It means a lot to have her here. It gives me hope.
What are you...
Yeah, go on, I'm a big softy.
Ow! Hey!
What?
Was that a dagger? Was it... What, you got a throwing star there? Whatever, you got something pokey on your hip.
I do not usually hug. You're a good friend, Peter.
Hey, Pete. I threw some mean words your way back there, and I wanted to apologize, you know. So, yeah. Sorry about that. I got worked up, you know? This whole Forge thing.
It's Rocket. We've got to accept it, right?
To deal with.
Hey, don't even worry about it, man.
Best friends forever?
Yeah, at least until death.
It's close enough.
I can tell these sounds bring you supreme joy! And also such sadness. You are a very nostalgic person.
Hey, whoa.
She's a very emotional person.
Why are you crying? Why am I crying?
Oh, that little box brings you so much sorrow. Oh, I'm sorry for that. Sometimes emotions overwhelm me and reflect back onto others.
Yeah, that's cool. I'm cool. Okay.
Everyone on this ship is... so poisoned by their feelings, overly focused on the past, not living here, in the now, experiencing all the wonderful things around you.
Like, I think it's better to focus on the future. You know, anything can be possible tomorrow.
That is a hopeful sentiment, and very naive, but sometimes you need that.
That's why I said it. For sure.
Thank you for letting me listen to your music. It made me feel better and worse at the same time. I loved it.
Oh God, there's so much in here. I should probably go through this at some point. It's always pretty good than the codex and knowledge bases that Telltale build into their games. I've always quite enjoyed it. For those who like a bit more of the lore. Oh, wow.
Hey, Mantis. Can you direct me to that magic shrine thing now?
Of course. But it is a long way, and I must concentrate completely. There can be no... There can be no distraction.
I didn't know it would do that.
Oh, you have made an awe-inspiring mess.
Distractions.
I'll see what I can do.
We'll be right back.
Wash away my troubles, wash away my pain. Where the rain and shambala. Wash away my sorrow, wash away
montage. It looks really cool.
The entrance to the shrine.
This place looks very cool indeed.
This is it.
Yay! Another temple!
The Kree were not only skilled warriors. You can find great symbolism in much of their architecture.
Yeah, yeah, they like pretty things. We get it.
Ah, Rocket. Always so pessimistic.
Any pointers?
It appears that the forge goes there. On the altar.
That's the forge? Oh no. The forge is in my hand. We're talking, yeah, okay. Confused.
Seriously? Well, that was anticlimactic.
Oh.
much, pal.
It's not working.
Relic in place. Check. Must be something else to it. Hey guys, have a look around. See if you can find anything that looks off.
I am Groot.
Of course something's wrong, because we're in a frickin' Creed temple, where everything is always more complicated than it needs to be. I mean, ain't they ever heard of an on switch?
Oh god, there's so much to do and... Alright, let's start here.
Anything?
The forge led me here, but has grown quiet.
How do you know I'll make the right choice about the forge?
I do not know that.
Oh.
You are the wielder of the Eternity Forge. It chose you. You must trust there's a reason.
Yeah, okay. No pressure at all. So, what now?
Repair the statues. Determine the fate of the universe.
Oh, is that all? So, are you glad you stayed with Gamora?
Yes. I think staying close to my sister is what's best for both of us.
I hope so. Because otherwise I'm pretty sure I'm gonna get the blame.
This place seems huge. There's two levels. We're on the first.
Well, we're about to seal the fate of the Eternity Forge.
Yes. Your decision will leave you despised by much of the team.
Good pep talk. Thanks, Drax.
No matter what you choose.
Yep, you can stop now. No matter what I decide about the Eternity Forge, you've got my back, right?
I am Groot.
Is that a yes? Or a no?
I am Groot.
How you holding up, buddy?
I am Groot.
Yeah, well, don't get your hopes up. He could still do the right thing and decide not to destroy the most useful artifact in the universe.
Okay. So Rocket's up there then. Don't think there's anything else to speak to at least. That's what I wanted to do. Have a look at this thing. Can't climb the steps. Okay. I don't know what made me come up here, but...
I think I see the problem. The alignment is all out of whack.
I'll whack it back so we can get on with it.
Okay, but I want to speak to Rocket first. I actually know where he is. Oh, is he there?
Once we get all these statues working, are you ready for whatever happens next?
That depends on you, Pete. You know how much bringing Lila back means to me. And only you can make that happen.
No pressure then. Okay, so I can't move that one. I can move this one. Why can't I go higher? A second.
There we go.
Because you don't need to go higher. That's the answer.
No, you were saying?
Rocket, tell Groot I need some help with the lens thingy.
Okay, okay.
I am Groot.
Yeah, good job, buddy.
Cheers.
Is going to be resurrected in no time.
I am Groot.
He says you might destroy him. That he hopes you do.
Is that really what he said? One more to go. Something tells me it's not going to be easy.
Oh, God. Why are they making me do all this before I decide whether to use it or destroy it? Awkward. I want to talk to him.
How are you holding up, Groot?
I am Groot.
I don't know. Hey, is that some kind of joke? Huh? Oh, cause, right. He's holding up the thing. That's...
No, it wasn't a pun. He's just an idiot.
Right, so I've done that one. I'm guessing there's going to be another. So let's see if we can do that. Are there three? Oh, yeah. Over there. What the hell?
How's it going, Gamora?
In a few minutes, we're gonna have to decide the fate of the Eternity Forge.
Not we. You. For whatever reason, this is all in your hands. Look, I know you haven't really sided with me or taken any of my advice lately, but the Forge is dangerous. You have to make sure no one can use it. Ever.
Okay, let's see. This big guy used to stand here, holding up that giant whatever it is thingy. Then things go bad. Age sets in.
Oh no, I dropped it! Ah!
So where did it go?
Okay.
There it goes.
Kind of rolled over in this direction, I want to say. Oh.
It is a hologram. You are so stupid.
Shut up. I knew that.
Do I have to find the disc? Quite sure what the game's trying to make me do. Oh, there we go.
What now, Celestial One?
The hell?
This thing really took a hit when that lens smashed into it.
It might still be intact under there.
That's what I'm counting on.
Stupid jet boots overheated.
Gutted. Gotta be Drax.
Can you help me lift that big stone off the lens?
Nope.
Well, all right then.
Wow. Talking about lending a hand. Shane up for it, apparently. It's not very nice, I'd say.
Drax, I need your muscles.
You cannot have them. They are attached to me.
No, I know they... I need your help. I've got to lift something very heavy.
Ah, I see. You are weak. I will help you. I am ready.
Cheers, Drax.
Can't quite reach.
Hey, Rocket. I need you to grab that lens.
Getting crushed to death ain't on my list of to-dos, Pete. I'm sure if you just reach really hard, you could get it. Maybe dislocating your shoulder or something?
I cannot fail.
Please, Rocket, I need you.
Ah, all right.
But I get smushed. I better be first in line for some resurrection.
Do it.
Here.
Thanks.
Interesting.
Stop.
But there is still no statue upon which to set it.
I would have gotten the lens, guys. I was just, you know, working up to it. Yep.
We'll have to work together as a team.
We just gotta, you know, work together.
Oh, you mean like a team?
What
an wow, idea. It's like I've seen this.
Yes.
I haven't.
Teamwork often brings good feelings.
Perhaps we are doing it wrong then.
Okay, listen up. I need everyone over here.
Nope, not gonna happen.
Just a little higher.
My arms can't go any higher.
Your muscles are soft.
Shut up.
Guys, stop talking.
Like a baby's bottom.
Shut up.
No, that's my face.
A very fat baby.
Sorry. Hey, what do I know about whatever you are, anatomy?
Idiots.
Maybe your people enjoy having their faces stepped on.
I did a thing.
It's done.
That mean I can drop this thing?
No.
These freaking temples. I'm gonna take dynamite to all of them.
Now it is truly time to decide.
Of course it is.
Turn the forge to the left to destroy it forever. Turn the forge to the right to empower it and bring it to its full potential.
Okay.
Wait, his right or your right?
Oh. I don't know.
What?
Let me see.
Wow. I can't believe that almost happened.
Turn it this way to destroy it. Turn it this...
Yeah, we got it. Turn it to the right, Pete.
It's left, Peter. You want your left.
Peter, you must turn it left.
No! It's right to empower you, idiot.
Oh, yes. Go right, Peter. I am Groot!
Destroying the forge is the only way we can keep it from hurting people.
Don't listen to her. Think of your mom. Think of Lila.
I am Groot.
Shut up already! He's gonna use it!
I promise you my undying loyalty. If you bring my family back to me.
Don't you see, Peter? Everyone wants this power, and no one should have it.
She's sorry. Right.
This thing is way too powerful for anyone to wield. You gotta destroy it.
Thank you, Peter.
You don't know anything about me, lady.
Perhaps she has never lost a loved one. She has only killed the loved ones of others.
Drax!
You don't talk like that to my sister.
I will talk to Gamora in whatever manner I please, robot. I am Groot.
Oh, yeah? And what would you know about it? You're a freaking piece of wood!
The process has begun. You can release it.
I am Groot.
You can't even communicate on your own. Think I like translating for you every single time?
I am Groot!
Now you're gonna start. Drax, back me up.
You are all horrible people.
No offense, Drax, but wisdom isn't your strong suit either.
Guys, we got company!
Thank you, Peter Quill.
You're welcome.
I never could have found this shrine without you. And the tracking device Jinsar placed on your ship.
Him.
You know, I didn't think you could get more annoying than that time you killed me. Man, you really suck.
Their usefulness has expired. Dispose of them.
Epic fight.
Not again! God, I have friggin' hate that thing. Oh, I've had about enough of this. God, boots are more busted than I thought. How you like me now, huh? Huh? No!
Goddamn boots.
Perish to the depths, blue demon.
He knows he can just let go, right?
Oh god. I thought I screwed that up then.
Drax! No, Anna! Come on, man, I can't breathe!
Stop the rodent!
Big blue lady. Not the first time. Intriguing. Will you let me have a minute?
Sheesh. Nice.
Now, where was I? Well, that was surprisingly easy. Hang on, buddy, I got you!
I'm sorry to have made you sad.
Oh, we should do this more often. Looks like the boys could use some help.
This won't be easy.
Hope not.
Ouch.
Ah. I'm okay. The Eternity Forge is mine.
What?
Paula, stop!
Valde, my son. Come back to me. Forge is no more.
Hope you're happy, Quill.
You did what needed to be done.
I did.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess so. Okay, so myself and 80% of the players used the word my words against the bully. Myself and 53% of the players let Nebula win. Myself and 94% of the players convinced Gamora to make up with Nebula. Myself and 94% of the players decided Nebula should stay. Obviously, some similar decisions across the board here, it would seem. You and 62% of players chose to destroy the Eternity Forge. Yeah, pretty good. Let's have a look at the next time on. Or not.
So now Mantis is tagging along, but she's only creating more questions than answers. About the Eternity Forge, about Hala, about everything.
Janitors of the galaxy, that's what we should be called. And Hala and the Kree, well, they're just the latest cosmic spill.
As much as he's wrong about almost everything he does, Peter was justified in his actions with the Forge.
She agreed with me? I mean, of course she did. Can I get a copy of her saying that?
It's what happened next that he should regret.
Intriguing, I guess. And there we have it. Okay, on that note, I think I'm going to call it for the evening. Wow, that's pretty good. I think we'll do episode 4 tomorrow. Or was that episode 4? No, yeah, episode 4 we'll do tomorrow. And maybe even the last one. We'll see how far we do. Anyway, thank you so much if you tuned in across the three platforms on which we are streaming, that being Mixer, Twitch, or of course YouTube. If you enjoyed what you saw, by all means follow the channel so you get those amazing notifications whenever we go live. And like I said, we'll hopefully be tuning in tomorrow to bring you some more of this particular game, Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy. My name's Rickie, you're watching Funky Gamer. Until next time, see you later.